Yeah, so these are going to be my 4x8 pockets for my 4x8, the top beams or the top plates to saddle in. And really all I did was I popped a line to find the center, because I found these aren't all exactly the same width. They're all close. They're just a hair over 8 inches. So I went 4 inches, 4 inches, marked both those lines, and right there in the middle is my center point. I did that on both ends. And then I measure out from my center line. So instead of measuring in from my sides to cut out a pocket, I'm trying to cut a center line, measure out. That way, you know, if I have a post that's just right at 8 inches or 8 1/4, all my joinery is measured off the inside, the center line, or close to center as I can get. So yeah, 8 inches depth, 4 inches wide. I'm gonna flip them over, do the same on the underside, mark it, and then we'll get to cutting them out. Thank you. Well, we've got chisel failure. Alright, so I got my top notches cut in my four interior posts. So I just cut some 4x8 notches. The top post will lay on those. I'm going to notch the posts where they run vertically side by side, and then I'll pin it all together with some dowels. So yeah, so that's done, and I did have a failure on my chisel. So this was a Narex chisel. It took a lot of pounding, but ultimately it didn't hold up. The little brass ferrule on the end started to give out, so the handle started to push up onto the chisel, which caused the handle to split. So it's got a good split going down the middle of it. So kind of bummed out about it. I have some bench chisels, some Stanley, the Sweetheart Reproduction bench chisels. So I was able to finish up with that. And it did give me an excuse to order. I ordered a Sorby timber framing chisel and a Sorby slick. So those should come in sometime next week, hopefully. And I'm excited about using those, especially the slick. I've always wanted one. I've kept not buying one, but figure if I'm doing all this, I might as well have one, right?